Welcome to part 2 of this video on the innervation of heart. Today we will talk about the physiology of innervation of the heart. Okay, before we really talk about the physiology of the heart, the first thing that we need to talk about is the distribution of the sympathetic and parasympathetic fibers to the musculature and the conducting system of the heart. Distribution. That fibers are distributed where in the heart? Most of the students consider that the innervation of the heart is almost to the every part of the heart, but that is not the case, as we will see. First of all, the sympathetic innervation of the heart is to the almost every cell of the heart and the almost every part of the heart, all musculature and conducting system. Okay, but in the case of parasympathetic, the main innervation is to the SA node and the AV node. But there is also some lesser stimulation to the atrial muscle. But the very important thing that you need to remember is that there is almost no innervation to the ventricular muscle. The ventricular muscle is only innervated by the sympathetics. They are not innervated by the parasympathetic. So there is no innervation of the almost no innervation of the parasympathetic on the ventricular muscle. Now let's talk about the effects of the sympathetics and parasympathetics on the heart. Let's first talk about the effects of the parasympathetic on the heart. The neurotransmitter that is released by the postsynaptic endings of the parasympathetic neurons innervating the heart is the acetylcholine. Now this acetylcholine causes two effects. First of all, it will cause the decrease in the rhythm of SA node. That, for example, first the SA node was firing at the rate of 100 beats per minute. Now it will be firing at the rate of 70 or 60 beats per minute. The thing is that the parasympathetic innervation decreases this SA node rhythm. Now the second effect is that very important thing is it decreases the excitability of atrial junctional fibers. Now, what is meant by the atrial junctional fibers? The atrial junctional fibers are the fibers that start from the SA node, passes through the atrial musculature and reach the AV node. Basically, it connects the atrial musculature to the AV node. Now, it will decrease the excitability of the atrial junctional fibers. By decreasing the excitability of the atrial junctional fibers, the parasympathetic innervation of the heart causes the slowing of the transmission of the impulses from the atria into the ventricle. Now, what will be the ultimate effect on the heart? That it will decrease the heart rate when there is the mild to weak innervation, when there is mild stimulation of the vagus nerve. But when there is very strong innervation, it can completely stop the heart. Now, when the impulses are not being transmitted by the atrial musculature into the AV node and there is no impulse reaching the AV bundle, the bundle of His and the Purkinje fibers and ultimately the ventricular muscle, there will be a delay of 5 to 20 seconds. In this 5 to 20 seconds, the ventricles will not contract and the heart will be completely at rest. But after some time, in some portion of the ventricular muscle, the automatic rhythmicity of another pacemaker starts and the heart starts to beat. This phenomena is called the ventricular escape. Now, let's talk about what will be the exact mechanism by which the parasympathetic innervation of the heart decreases the heart rate and the excitability of the heart. Now, basically the acetylcholine that is released at the cardiac muscle, it will cause the formation of increase potassium channels in the heart muscle membrane, myocardial membrane, and it will also open the already present potassium channel, so that the potassium which is inside the cell, almost every cell of the body has an abundant concentration of potassium. This potassium that is present inside the cell will start leaking out. Now, as the potassium ions are positively charged, so that the resting membrane potential inside the cell will reduce, so that the, for example, the in the case of the SA node, the resting membrane potential is minus 55 to minus 60 normally. But when the parasympathetic innervation of the heart acts, it will decrease this minus 55 to minus 60 to minus 65 to minus 75 millivolt. The outgoing leakage of the potassium, the out leakage of the potassium will lead to the decrease in the resting membrane potential. Now, when this resting membrane potential is decreased, much longer time is required for the sodium ion and potassium, sodium ion and calcium ions to cause the repolarization of this membrane, and in this way the SA node rhythm will be reduced. And in the same way, at the atrial junctional fibers, it will delay the transmission of the impulses from the atria into the AV node, through the atria into the ventricle through the AV node, because there is now the muscle membrane is hyperpolarized. The term that is used is the hyperpolarized. Now let's talk about what will be the effect of the sympathetics on the heart. The sympathetic innervation of the heart is from the, as you all know, from the T1 to T6 level through the superior cervical ganglion. Now, this will cause, as you all know, that the sympathetics are distributed to every part of the heart musculature and the conducting system. The sympathetic, first of all, they will increase heart rate. They will increase heart muscle contractility, because there is, unlike the parasympathetic innervation, there is the innervation of the heart, the innervation of the sympathetics on the ventricular musculature. They will also increase the speed of conduction, the speed by which the impulse is conducted along the conducting system of the heart, along the nerve fibers, and they will also increase the excitability of the fibers. Now, not in Guyton, but in some books, there are the terms called the positive inotropic, positive chronotropic, positive dromotropic, and positive bathymotropic action. The sympathetics will cause all four actions of the heart. It will increase heart rate, it will increase the heart contractility, the force with the heart contracts, it will increase the speed of conduction of the impulse along the heart muscle and the heart conducting system, and it will also increase the excitability of the muscle fiber membrane, so that it will be more excitable and the threshold for excitation will be reduced. Now, what will be the mechanism of action of the sympathetics on the heart? Mechanism by which the sympathetics acts on the heart. Basically, the neurotransmitter that is released at the sympathetic nerve endings of the heart is the norepinephrine, and it will act on the beta 1 receptors. It will act on the beta 1 receptors which are present on the heart. Now, do not confuse between the beta 1 and the beta 2 receptors. I will tell you about the function of the beta 2 receptors later in this video. First, you will have to remember the beta 1 receptors which are present on the heart musculature and on the heart conducting system. When the norepinephrine acts on the beta 1 receptor of the myocardial muscle membrane, it will cause the increase inside movement of sodium ions and calcium ions. In this way, the increased sodium ion and the increased calcium ion will increase the SA node rhythm. When sodium ions and calcium ions are more entering inside the SA nodal fibers muscle membrane, the rhythm of the heart will be increased. When this calcium ions will enter the ventricular muscle fibers, they will cause the muscle fiber to contract more strongly. When these sodium and calcium ions are entering into the myocardial muscle fibers and the conducting system of the heart, they will increase the excitability of the heart. The resting membrane potential will be increased, and when these fibers are more excitable, then the speed of the conduction of the heart, speed of conduction of the impulse along the heart fibers will also be increased. Okay, now let's talk about the beta 2 receptors. Talk about the innervation of beta 2 receptor. That what is the function of beta 2 receptor? We have already talked about the beta 1 receptors. The beta 2 receptors are present only on the coronary arteries, which supply the arterial blood to the arterial blood to the heart musculature. Now this beta 2 representation on the coronary arteries is only a minor one, but nevertheless we will have to talk about it. The beta 2 innervation on the heart will cause the dilation of the coronary arteries, the mild dilation of the coronary artery, so that more and more blood is supplied to the heart when there is the sympathetic stimulation of the heart. Most of the time the coronary arteries are not left at the mercy of the sympathetic nervous system. The coronary arteries, just like the cerebral arteries, are maintained by the autoregulation mechanism. The dilation and contraction of the coronary arteries is regulated by the autoregulatory mechanism that we will talk about in another video. Now here we are done with the physiology of the heart. There is another video on the innervation of the heart with the anatomy of the innervation of the heart. If you have any questions, you can ask. Thank you very much. Please subscribe to my channel, click the bell icon and share with your friends. Thank you.